FTM warrant.
So I move.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Last on the list, we move from first, we have Fort Getty Restroom bid award. Bruce?
Yeah, we've been discussing for some time now the need to upgrade the restrooms primarily for health and safety, but also aesthetic reasons. Obviously, last year we heard a great deal from campers about some of the significant concerns they had about the existing conditions, which had not, the bathrooms hadn't upgraded in decades, and were sorely in need of improvement. We had considered entirely new restroom on the north end, and with $250,000 of money that we have set aside from a prior year's capital budget reserves. But in looking at where we are in the Fort Getty master plan conversation, and having reached conclusions as to what configuration of the Fort Getty activities will be going forward, we felt it was, for small amounts of money, it was best served the town to upgrade the existing facilities in order to address the problems that are there. And so we're making a recommendation to completely revamp the interior of the restrooms on the north end of the Fort Getty, as well as near the pavilion, which here receives heavy traffic both from campers as well as from users of the pavilion itself. New styles have already been installed in both structures. That is giving great ventilation as well as removing some of the darkness of those facilities. So minor improvements can go a long way to making the experience a whole lot better. But in addition to those measures, we're looking at the removing and installing all of the fixtures in each of the two facilities. It includes moving and installing 5 new pressure-assisted toilets, moving and installing 4 new countertop lavatories with faucets, moving and installing other toilets in the men's restrooms, moving and installing 2 new board rings, installing a new temperature valve that will take care of lab faucets, installing new plumbing, shutoffs, piping, and supports for necessary insulation. And for that work, we're looking to bring power plumbing in the budget. And they bid $4,200 per facility. We are buying all material under our municipal account, since we're general contract serving the GC on this job, so that we get the tax exempt status and we reduce the cost of materials. For the tile work, we're renovating both the men's and lady showers, acid washing, repairing, installing, new tile and grout, and sealing all existing grout. And the work is for Bill Sullivan of Middletown, Rhode Island, and his bid is at $1,950 per site.
May I ask if we're putting water-free urinals in those facilities?
Excuse me?
Are we putting water-free urinals in those facilities, or are we using full flush urinals? So we're using water.
Yeah. We decided that it worked out last year where it's an automated system where we flush twice a day rather than constant flush when they're with you. So it seemed to work out. We had zero complaints on it. We thought about the waterless, but we thought with the use that it gets, it would just...
No, I think that's a better solution. I didn't know that was available. It was an option.
We did that last year. It worked out very well.
Yeah.
Do you mean going to have separate bid awards?
Yes. One to Harold Plumbing.
Okay, that's what I was trying to get down to. Dollar amount.
So it's Harold Plumbing in the amount of $8,400?
Yes.
Do we have a motion?
I move that we approve the Harold Plumbing bid for $8,400.
$8,200.
No. It's $8,400. It's $4,200.
Yeah, so it's $8,400.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And who is the $3,900? The other one is actually $4,000. Yeah, $3,900. You're right there. Yeah,
Bill.
Yeah. And that's Bill Sullivan Incorporated of Middletown, Rhode Island.
Okay, I move that we approve the bid for the award contract to Bill Sullivan for $3,900.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Any other administrative issues tonight? Excellent. So we have executive session right now?
I move we break into executive session.
Second.
Pursuant to Rhode Island.